Our next stop on the social distancing wine tour was at, well, it was at Horsetail, which actually was a visit to Beaufrère, where Mikey Etzel is the head winemaker. And then this is a side label that he produces partially at Beaufrère, as well as another production space. But we visited him at Beaufrère, so take a look at this.
All right, so we're here with Mikey Etzel of Coattails Winery. But we're actually in the facility here of Beaufrère. That's because his dad is the founder of Beaufrère. But Mikey has since taken on the job of head winemaker at Beaufrère as well. But Coattails is also a project that he started with his brother Jared. I don't know, did Coattails come before you took on head winemaker at Beaufrère?
Much
before.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, so we're going to be featuring the 2017 Horsetail Pinot Noir. And tell us a little bit about that wine, some of the sources for the fruit,
yeah,
and what the maybe the stylistic approach to that.
Sure. Horsetail is actually the first wine that my brother and I made in 2007. We were still at Oregon State University studying enology viticulture, and we wanted to apply the books to a more practical aspect and banded together with our classmates and made this wine. We didn't know what it was going to be. 2007 was a challenging vintage, classic now, I think, and more appreciation for it. But we made this wine. It was a little light on its feet, for even though Pinot Noir should be that. But it was perhaps simple, and a little more simple. And we decided it was going to be less of an ambitious product than what we thought it was going to be. So we made this label and named it Horsetail, as after the Equisetum plant. Being common, more of a common herb, you know, it's a nuisance actually in most areas, but in biodynamic farming, it's actually a kind of a cherished plant for its ability to, when dynamized in a way, to combat disease pressure in the vineyard. We use it actually a bit. Fast forward a decade, here we are, 2017 vintage Horsetail. We continue making for it being based off of barrels out of our entire whopping 500 case production that don't have the opulence and the tannin profile that we see it being able to be a really age-worthy wine. So it's usually brighter and lighter, and you just kind of call it a pop and pour. And it's a blend, depending on the vintage, of the 2 to 3 vineyards that we work with. Sometimes it's press fractions. Sometimes it's a single barrel of a small fermenter that we made from the vineyard. In 17, it's a blend of just two vineyards, Jesse James and the Olamide Hills, that I farm and co-lease with a friend of mine. And Beaufrère, and Sequitur Vineyard, my father's retirement vineyard, which we can talk about, I guess, in a minute. I hope I'm not taking too long.
No, this is great.
But, yep, 17 was a high-yielding, warm vintage with a good punch of rain at the end to kind of make sure it was still Oregon and not some other warm growing region.
Yeah.
And I think it's shown great.
Great. Now, the group of wines that I'm going to tuck this into is going to be marketed as my sustainable wines.
Mm-hmm.
So talk a little bit about the farming practices behind this and where you like to come from as far as like ensuring that things are sustainable and you know, in harmony with the earth.
Yeah, we are certainly an entity and a family that has been sort of, well, after we got drilled in the head and before with science, after we got this enology viticulture degree, we still came back to what I think my dad is the primary root source of our mantra, that being that we are farming soil and the vine is a byproduct of that, and as healthy of a soil as you can create is going to create this expression in the glass of whatever you're growing. Pinot Noir, it is an even more dynamic grape, and it's a bit of a selfish reason, but that's a big part. Then the sustainability factor is a huge part too. So Beaufrère is organically and biodynamically produced estate, and the two sources of grapes that come from this are basically nothing different than how Beaufrère farms. Certainly my father's vineyard, which is attached to our upper terrace vineyard, it's just right next to it. It's farmed by the same people and at the same time. And the same thing with Jesse James, as Beaufrère and my friend and myself farm this vineyard. We haul our equipment over to the vineyard. We have the same people handling the vines, and we are an environmentally responsible farming outfit, I would say.
Perfect.
Which is great. Seems very important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great. Well, thanks for taking the time today. And again, 2017, Coattails Horsetail.
Thanks for the support. Appreciate it. And happy to see the world is not ending. Cheers.
Cheers.